Hi, everybody. Welcome back to episode 4. Once again, joined with
the editor.
What yeah, up? Let's go. Whoa. And today, you know, episode 4. So, Reach, it's finally here. The invasion part. So, this is like a day later, so my notes are kind of rusty, so apologize. I apologize if I kind of blank out in here and there. Frank is friends with pigeons.
Yeah, that's what I said too. Yeah, I was like, Frank meets pigeons. Like, that's cool.
Frank meets the pigeon gang. I love that
while
scene.
While I was editing the video, I watched and I was like, his name isn't Frank. I'm like, what is it? And I searched up online. It's like Vanek. I'm like, it's not Vanek anymore. It's
no,
Frank.
Nope, it's Frank. We've canonized it. We've canonized Frank. It. Yeah, anyways. he's friends with some pigeons, and they go cool, cool, crazy. And then the glass scene, or attacks. Mm-hmm. I said put glass scene here, but probably when watching the video, I'm going to be like, oh, no, it was just a few attacks. But I don't know. It probably was the glass scene.
I think it was bombs. Was it bombs?
Probably artillery. Probably artillery fire.
Yeah.
I think it's literally just called Hail Mary.
Because I think the glassing happened after. Cause
yeah, the glassing was the very last thing to happen.
Ahead of ourselves. Yeah, I think they said the glassing was happening soon.
Because the glass scene, and this is just like standard logic if you're going to glass a planet, which sounds weird, but if you're going to glass something, usually that's the very last thing to do. You don't just immediately glass it unless you're in the Star Wars. We have a, like, shell-shocked Perez moment. Perez gets, like, shell-shocked or something like that.
That's her name. I did not even know what her name was.
I only remembered it just because it was said so much to the point where it was engraved in my brain what this woman's name was.
Was that episode 1 and episode 2?
Yeah. Master Chief was like, Whisperers, and I was just like, okay, yeah, I get it. Her name's Perez. I do not care. And I find it funny how Master Chief is just like standing there menacingly, showing no facial expression, nothing. I'm remembering this scene now. That's why I'm starting to laugh. He's just standing there.
Yeah.
Then we cut to the fight with the Covenant Elite. I don't know if anyone else noticed when Master Chief got punched in the stomach that if I paused it right there to write down this note, when I looked back, I was like, oh my gosh, that's such horrible CGI. And the more I thought about it, the more I remembered. So in Star Wars Episode 3, Sidious versus Yoda, right? The guy who plays Sidious literally had to swing at the ground with absolutely nothing being there, if I remember correctly. So... and they still made it look like Yoda was always there and
like
he was real. You know, that's why I love episode 3 so much, is because the guy was just swinging at the ground in a specific order.
Yeah,
and it looked so much better than Master Chief getting punched in the gut by an elite. Like,
it's the same thing with like the elevator scene I was talking about, where the two Oni guys in there, and Master Chief punches one and kicks the other, and he like goes back. Like, it's so delayed. It just looks fake. It's like, oh my gosh.
Yeah.
It's
so.
Yeah.
And then they recap how Master Chief was found, and I put it as Master Chief has his Halo 3 luck moment.
Yeah.
I don't know. And then, and I even timestamped it. At 11:50, if you look in the background, there is an original Xbox show.
Yeah, I knew that, too.
I loved that.
I was like, that's so cool.
Yeah.
I'm like, even all the typewriters and keyboards, I'm like, that's an Xbox. Yeah, I'm like, that is Xbox. Full of shit.
And for a second there, I thought they were acknowledging it when, like, the store owner was, like, talking about, like, oh, we gotta keep our past. You see that right there? I thought she was pointing out the Xbox. Also, I'm pretty sure that keyboard is the Halo 117 keyboard. I could be totally wrong, but it looked like it to me. Lore, like emotional lore, I put that down because like the shop woman was like, oh, what happens if we don't keep our past and whatnot and blah blah blah. I don't know why I remember this so much.
Surprisingly, she even talked about fighting communism. Like, you really want to talk about that right now? When like
she did?
Not trying to here, but yeah, she was like, we fought through communism.
Oh yeah, communism and socialism.
Funny that you would say that, because there's actually some people out there that think communism and socialism Communism is all right.
Yeah. Communism is actually kind of tough.
Yeah, and like, it's
I'm not I'm siding with anything. I'm just saying but hey, I'm fine for it.
I get where you're coming from, and and then, oh, by the way, there's more of the subplot happening with, like, Halsey and the pirate guy, and I don't care for it. I didn't skip over anything this time, believe it or not.
I didn't skip over anything,
but, like, I kind of found it weird how Spartan 66 chose to be a Spartan unlike everyone else, and apparently, like, he was essentially this universe's Noble Six, because Noble Six was the first to beat everything. This guy chose to be a Spartan, and everyone, including Master Chief, looked up to him. So, yeah. I mean, like, hey, cool, I guess. Speaking of which, Noble Team is not shown. So far, I'm having high hopes that they're not going to be shown.
I love you, directors. That was so cool. Such a good decision.
Thank goodness. Imagine Noble Six just shows up.
Community, but you have not hurt the other yet.
Noble Six just shows up in the finale, like, what's up? I'm going to actually help you all leave.
Oh man, that would be so terrible.
The final episode is just titled Lone Wolf. Everyone immediately, oh no.
Lone Wolf. I'm like, no. I'm getting PTSD flashback.
Everyone immediately recognizes what that means.
Oh man, that would be so terrible.
Riz is the first person found, and oh yeah. Cortana is shown again, and from what I got from the scene, it looked like McKee was controlling her, or was that just her touching the artifact? I don't know.
So I think she already got there first and then took Cortana.
Yeah, probably. I don't know, it looks like she was controlling it from what I saw. That's what I put in the notes. Yeah. And then
because what I thought was like they got there and she was like, oh, you're here, and then like disappeared, and then she was there. And I'm like, oh, she got there first to Cortana somehow.
Yeah, I guess. I don't know. I just know I don't like McKee.
Dr. Halsey said, like, oh, no, they took Cortana.
They got Cortana. They got my clone.
They have my kid.
Yeah. It's a Boba Fett, Jango Fett scenario. Oh, no, they took my kid, which is also technically myself. Did I just get kidnapped? Wait, if Boba Fett was, if Boba Fett was ever kidnapped, could Jango Fett say he was kidnapped?
Oh man, that's funny. You're thinking about it.
Yeah. Perez is like telling Master Chief if he has anything to say to her, and I put that in my notes as Perez gets rejected by Mustard Beef. Lol.
Dang, Mustard Beef
over here. Also, no armor. Like they straight up like admit that there is gonna be no armor. Like, Key says something about, oh, your armor, or was it Frank who said something about the armor? I don't know. Someone said something about no armor, and yeah, the Spartans don't wear any armor in this one.
Because evil British guy took him.
Yeah, we all love evil British guy. Let's give it a round of applause for him.
If he works for, like, a super evil secret company, why would you take the suits? Can't you guys just build more? Like, I'm assuming they have a lot more Spartans.
Yeah, why don't they have, like, spare? Well, actually, if the context clues that I've picked up to this point say anything, it's that every single Spartan unit was taken away from Reach except Silver Team, and then Kaya had already asked to be redeployed, which is why she isn't there. At least I think. I don't know. I didn't watch all the scenes with her and British Man because I was dying of cringe. But I'm pretty sure that only Silver Team is down there with a bunch of Marines that were left behind. Keys literally just straight up chose to go down there. I don't know. Feel free to correct me. But that's the context clues that I've got. And then mid-speech scene, honestly, not going to lie. I didn't like when... I mean, it was good at first, but then I didn't like how they go John and like, you know, look, it's Master Chief, but look, he ain't got no armor.
To save you, but he's got no armor, so you're all gonna die here today.
Guys,
so, spoiler alert, he gets himself killed anyway, so you know,
yeah. We'll get to that later. A scorpion / the halo tank is shown. I actually like that. I thought that was pretty good, and it shoots white phosphorus.
You can see all the elites coming. That was kind of cool. I think I like that scene a lot.
I kind of like that scene because I don't know. It was one of those twists that you were kind of like, I don't know. And then you were kind of like, is it just going to be a blank or whatnot? So it actually did have me a bit on edge. Like, oh, what's actually really going to happen? And are they really here? Are they really not? So, yeah, good job. Cool. And Keys might be dead.
I think he is dead.
I don't know why I put might. I'm playing the scene. I'm playing the scene in my brain, and I'm like, he's dead. He doesn't have anything. He's dead.
Somehow, Keys returned. Oh my gosh!
Noble Six just walking out with Keys. Yo, look what I found. Oh wait, right next to I put probably is totally dead.
Probably is totally okay. Yeah, see you now.
Yeah, there we go.
But do you?
I actually thought that scene, aside from like hearing the Halsey screaming, was actually really well done. I like the explosion and the whole God of Light thing. It kind of reminded me a bit of Halo 3, Johnson, not gonna lie.
I don't get this. Is it me, or does that actor seem so much better playing like Sergeant Johnson?
Yes, that is literally what everyone said.
And I'm like, you would be perfect if you probably lost the beard, like the white beard, and played Sergeant Johnson. You would. I can see him saying, I know what the lady's like. It would be perfect.
Master Chief uses an energy sword. And I actually thought that was going to have high potential, because I see energy swords as kind of like a lightsaber of the Halo universe. And then McFreaking dies.
Gets knocked.
Apparently, energy swords aren't lightsabers. They got bonked, and then he immediately got shot with a plasma pistol. And I legitimately thought they killed him, and that was like my sleeper activation coach. I just snapped and like actually was fully attached to my monitor. I was really focused, like, wait a minute. The Elite cuts off the head of the other Elite that shot Master Chief.
That was such a cool scene, because he's like, oh, you took what I was fighting. He's like, yeah, just like, off his head. I was like, wow.
Yeah, that was
cool. That's a cool way of showing how brutal these Elites are. Like,
yeah, really no, very good way of fleshing out your enemy characters. Also, apparently, Chief is still alive, by the way, so the other guy who literally just murdered his own Elite is like, oh wait, he's still alive. Never mind, McKee's gonna prevent me from killing this man.
I did not get that. I'm like, you're an Elite, you killed your own teammate on the battlefield to kill this one dude, and then this woman lady is just like, or human woman is just like, no, don't kill him. He's like, alright, I guess I won't. It's like, you already killed one of your own, like, you know, brothers or whatever, and then like a girl's gonna tell you no. Like,
we call this simper.
All this simp. I don't think you are a true Giga Chad.
Dude, like, he murders own teammate, about to murder enemy. Woman says no, proceeds to no longer elaborate. And oh
man,
I don't know.
Out there,
I hate McKee. I'm gonna be flat out honest.
The worst in the entire series.
Yeah, just
she makes the pirate side plot look so much more cooler.
Yes. Like, I'm telling you right now, all right? Y'all can even quote me in the comments on this. I would rather watch every single bit of the pirate subplot from like season 1 to season 2 instead of look at McKee for 5 seconds.
I agree. 1000%. I agree. All right. It's
Also, lads, we lost a true one. Frank is dead. They got Frank. They killed him.
They killed him with one needle bullet. I don't know how you could do that, but that's not how the Halo 3 is.
I know. So I was thinking of when I finished writing all of this, I immediately thought of Kat getting sniped. Like, I'm not joking. I'm like,
I did not think that.
Like,
God.
So here's what I mean. All right. Let me back up. Let me back up a bit.
Yeah.
So when Frank first uses the needler, right, it's bouncing off the Elite, which already contradicts what a needler is supposed to do. A needler tracks and penetrates the armor on purpose, really and like it's supposed to hold there. So already that's a big flaw. But when the Elite grabs it, it should have exploded immediately. Because they're meant to explode on high impact. That's why that's why they'll grab onto your Spartan and then you explode and die. Because that's
like
how
a
needler works.
Impact, like, oh.
Yeah.
like,
not how that works.
No, no. So when he grabbed it, that's also a contradiction, because yeah. it would have, and also counting the time from like actual multiplayer to this, I would argue it took more time to detonate in the show than it will ever do in your multiplayer matches.
In your multiplayer matches,
I swear it took more time.
Yeah.
And then like stabbed right there, like, and then it exploded.
Yeah.
I immediately, like, at first I was, when I first saw it, I was, like, snapped, and I was like, wait, I literally shouted, no, they killed Frank for a second.
Yeah.
But then, after, like, 10 minutes later, I'm like, so you're telling me Kat could have just pulled it out of her head?
Yeah.
Because, mind like, you, he's not wearing any armor, so I understand the explosion.
Yeah.
Also, it would not leave that big of an impact, but, like, yeah, Kat was in full Mjolnir armor and gets headshotted by probably the exact same, if not maybe a bit longer.
I think, for Kat's death, like, I think I saw online the reason why she was immediately killed was because EMP blast went off, and then all the shields on their Spartans got, you know, basically, like, off. So
yeah, it was the weapon choice.
Like, yeah. But she's still wearing the armor.
Yeah, and, like, the Elite is wearing the armor, and it doesn't even go through. So, technically speaking, anyways, I don't know. I immediately thought of that, like, 10 minutes afterwards, and I was like, I have to include that. It's not in my notes, but I just have to include that.
Yeah.
And, I really thought that ending, like, actually made me feel kind of like, wow, everything's lost. Because, like, you got the hangar being overrun, you got the grounds being overrun, Frank is dead, Master Chief is essentially dead. And
not Master Chief, no. Mustard Beef.
Oh, right, I forgot. Mustard Beef. Sorry, Paramount. Enjoy your copyright claim, by the way, Paramount, thanks. That's essentially all of my notes. I know that's pretty short. You're probably like, well, wait, that's it? But this episode was 43 minutes long. What else do you want me to say? Halsey was screaming? Spartan 66 was existing? I don't know what else to say. This was a short episode. What?
Yeah, I have a little bit of in my notes that I forgot about. I know one of the things I said is kind of dumb now that I think about it, but what I said, I was like, the episode was cool, but I hate how they change a lot from the series from the game, like the battle rifle being full auto.
Yes, that's okay. That's what I was trying to remember. Yeah. Was real quickly. Let me jump in here real quickly just because you made me remember something. I'm sorry. Real quickly. Okay. Why is every single weapon full auto now?
It's so annoying. And the other thing I had, which I can see why it's dumb now, but the thing I wrote in my notes while I was thinking about it, I was like, the needler bullet that hits the dude, I was like, blows up in one hit, unlike taking a hailstorm to blow up in the game. But now that I think about it, they had armor in the game.
Yeah,
so yeah. And I think,
That's about it. 8.2 out of 10. Actually, my favorite episode so far. I liked the action. I liked kind of how quick to pace it was. I liked the pigeons. I liked everything. Not everything. I liked almost everything. The pigeons carried. That's all I gotta say. Christian Master Chief. Where is he?
Christian Master Chief. What happened? Where is it at?
Where is it at? Noble 6 converts Master Chief to Christianity. Yes! Yes!
Let's go! I think my rating for this episode would probably be... I don't know. It's good. I love the action. The action was super cool.
Mm-hmm.
But the story was kind of whatever. So I think overall, I'm going to give it like... 7, maybe an 8. Because it was better than the other episode, but...
Yeah. That's why I gave it an 8.2 because I absolutely love almost anything with action. Like, I don't know why. Yeah, that's just my personal reasoning for giving it those 0.2 points.
Mm-hmm.
I will say I would probably remove a point because just of how, I guess you could say, grounded Master Chief and the other Spartans kind of were in this. It didn't really feel like Halo. It more felt like...
the Marines.
Marines perspective. I don't like Perez a lot. I kind of don't like how they kept going back to her and how I mean, it would be fine if you had her just like letting the transport go away to help driving that. But it like the shell shock perspective and that one shot where like she helped get the wounded. I get that's kind of story building, but dude, that's just not necessary. I don't know.
We're not here for side characters. We're here for Master Chief.
We're here for mustard beef and mustard beef alone. Nah, you're fine. Mustard beef. Yeah. That's my rant done. Yep. Holy cow, that was almost 30 minutes. Dang.
I can't wait to edit this.
See you, Spartans, and remember, use hashtag Christianized Master Chief.